Puck comes back around on the right side and cleared up to center ice. Brown comes into the game, third in the NHL, and hits with 42. And Scuderi and Nash meet along the boards. Kings have it. And we're going to get the...
Blue Jacket player Bob is still down on the ice. It's Jason Chimera. He's talking with the ref right now. No. Dorsett comes all the way across. Now, this would be an automatic. This should be an automatic. It's not going to be an instigator right here, but he's going a little bit too far here. You can get in trouble, obviously, with excessive contact with an official. Now, Rob Scuderi went low on the hit. Now, you can see that Chimera's cut. Nothing in the past as far as reputation with that man right there, Rob Scuderi, would tell you there would be anything dirty about his play. And it looked to me like a hip check that caught Chimera off guard. Chimera going down the boards. We'll see what actually makes contact. Yeah, he does go low. Now, Chimera will hit his head on the ice. That's the reason for the cut. And now we have this continued on the ice. Head over heels, I guess, is the description right there. And you see Rick Nash come in. Then all the Blue Jackets. Matthew Roy was involved. Now, that was low, Bob. I'm going to have to say that. It was low. It was at the legs. Now, the injury that's caused is the cut, because his head hits the ice. Now, I know there's been a lot of talk, and Chimera's over at the Kings bench, and he's pointing fingers, so... I'll be honest, I don't blame him for being upset there. The hit was low. Now, again, a lot of people are probably looking at the cut and going, what's going on and what happened? And, well, it's his head hitting the ice because he went so far off balance. There's Rob Scuderi, so... Chimera was fair game. He just had the puck. He just dished it off. So we'll take a look right there as Chimera's on the bench and just getting taken care of. Again, the total contact. You see how low that contact is right here, right into the knee. So that's going to upset players. And Bob, I mentioned the reputation of Rob Scuderi. He does not, by any means, have a reputation for being dirty. And you can see that in the old days, Bob, that's a good hip check. I mean, back in the day, that's a great hip check. It's a solid play. Nothing wrong with it. Lately, they've been talking about hits below the waist, things of that sort. By no means would I ever say, and I don't think that was the case there, that Rob Scuderi would go after anyone's knees. He was finishing a check, he did so. And now the Blue Jackets, I would assume the Blue Jackets would have to pay for their reaction here with some sort of penalty against them.
Well, the referees are still discussing it all over the linesman. The referees right in front of the penalty timekeeper, as you see Chimera. There they are in this discussion here, because the reaction was Lessard was the one that came over first, I believe, for the Blue Jackets, was it not? Or Dorsett?
Yeah, Dorsett. Now, Bobby, we have to... I'm making the assumption Dorsett was already on the ice. There's a whole bunch of things that can go on, a quick change and things of that sort, but the reaction of the Blue Jackets is understandable. Well, I mean, if it happened against the Kings, you'd want a similar type of reaction. When you do make that reaction, though, you have to pay for it with some type of a penalty. And I'm glad to see Chimera's okay. I think he's okay. He's cut. But I think overall he's going to be okay, because it can obviously be dangerous when you hit your head on the ice in any fashion. And there's Scuderi over on the bench. So this is going to be an ongoing storyline as this game continues. And I'm sure the Blue Jackets, trailing 2-0, are already frustrated even more by the hit of Rob Scuderi.
Well, Columbus apparently going to get a too many men on the ice and a game misconduct. They're going to announce the penalties now.
That may mean, Bob, that Dorsett left the bench.
Right.
And Dorsett gets a game misconduct. If he did leave the bench to get involved, in that altercation, that would be a case for supplemental discipline, and it would look at that for future suspensions of Derek Dorsett. And actually, Chimera's the guy's coming over to the penalty bench, so that's... Well, now he's taking the U-turn going the other way. So
I think he got a 10-minute misconduct.
Okay, yeah. So he will not play for at least the rest of this period. It'll be a minute and 4 seconds in the second period before Chimera is going to be able to come back on the ice. So the Kings should end up with at least that 5-on-4 power play with the too many men on the ice, the only minor called on the entire altercation.
In addition to the too many men on the ice, Derek Dorsett is out of the game with a game misconduct, and Chimera, the man who was cut, gets a 10-minute misconduct.
And there are ramifications too, Bob, for any player that leaves the bench for the coach. And again, that's the one thing that really ended players coming off the bench when they started penalizing the coach as well. And again, you understand the reaction. Yeah, but when you overreact, you have to pay for it. They're paying for it there, and Dorsett will pay for it tonight, and probably will pay for it a little bit. And then you also have that contact with the linesman. Probably, certainly not premeditated by any means, and it wasn't a reaction to the officials, but you can get also a 3-game suspension for any unnecessary contact with officials.